Welcome to another episode of My Doll Diaries. Now, if you don't know me already, my name is Claire and I run two series of videos on YouTube, one called The Stitch Diaries and one called The Doll Diaries. Now, I am filming in my bedroom today. I haven't been feeling wonderful this last week and it's just, it's very cold at the moment and it's lovely and warm in here, so I've decided to film in here. Now, today I am going to bring you a Barbie doll unboxing. And basically it's all about the hair. That's why I look like this. So I will take these out in a moment, but I've just left it like this so you could have a good look at these. Now, I got into this little doll adventure. Well, I started picking up a few secondhand dolls back in 2015, started collecting Harry Potter dolls in 2022, then picked up a brand new Barbie doll near the end. Was it near the end? No, probably near the end. Well, I don't know, but basically 2022. Ended up being a big doll year for me. I was having a difficult year and yeah, and it's just kind of gone from there. But when I got into it, I really wanted to find a gadget I used to have when I was a little girl. And it was a gadget that does this to your hair. Now, you couldn't believe my excitement as a grown-up lady when I found that gadget to do my own hair like it. And this is what it does. Now, the gadget I use is this, and it's called the Insta Twist, and it says quick and easy twist and braid effects. Now, I've had this years and it's really clever. Now, I basically was desperate to find the gadget I had when I was a little girl to do it to Barbie, and they can get them, but they're quite a high price on eBay and things. So I did find out if there was a new doll that had one, and there was, but I wasn't entirely convinced if you could use it on any doll. I'm still not 100% sure, but we're going to find this out today. And then I didn't end up buying it because I thought, oh, I kind of left it because I wasn't sure. But then recently this doll went on sale because there's a brand new one. Now, this doll is aimed at probably the younger audience of Barbie. It's a Dreamtopia, which is like a Barbie TV series aimed at younger children. But this is a Dreamtopia doll, but they've basically brought out a new Dreamtopia doll with, I guess, the same gadget. Now, what I'll do is I'll pop a photograph up on the screen of the new one that's come out. I'll have a look for that online because I have seen it. And then I'll pop a photograph of the one that I've bought. Now, I've managed to save myself £10 buying the older version, and today I'm going to find out if I can do the twist on other dolls' hair. Now, I've got a doll that has got a twist anyway, and I use this as one of my minis. So she's got the twist here, but she was an old doll. It was Barbie and Tanner the dog doll. And why I liked her, she got dark eyes. I may have darkened her eyes some more, maybe. I can't quite remember now because I do mess with dolls a little bit. Yeah, her hair came like this. She's not on the body she came in. I put her on one of the yoga bodies. I changed the heads so she's got a bit more flexibility. And she's actually in a jumper that I knitted because I've got a jumper. I can actually see my jumper that is this colour. It's not knitted. It's a sweater jumper, like a Nike brand one. And it's over there and it's the same colour, so we can do twinning is winning, and we've both got the leggings and things as well. Actually, this is a shop bought jumper. I haven't knitted this jumper, but it is knitted, and it's H&M, and it's actually a pale pink and orange. And if you in the current Barbie series of TV, I'm sorry if this camera is shaking, I'll try not shake too much. I've got the tripod on the bed. Barbie's bedroom, well, do you know, in Barbie's dream house adventures when she lives at home with her parents and her sisters, her bedroom is pink and orange, like a pale pink and orange. So yeah, I feel very Barbie today. So anyway, so this doll already has a twist in it, and this is the doll I'm going to try and put a twist in if I can. Now, this doll, this originally was meant to be my mini, and she was a doll. She was already a yoga doll doll on this body, but she had brunette hair, so I actually pulled all her hair out. It was quite painful actually, pulling all her hair out. And actually, because I love this doll so much, I actually bought her again, so I've actually got her in her original state with her brown hair, because I love her. But yeah, but this one I bought some hair on eBay, and I basically, yeah, I rerouted it, and I ended up just leaving it as long as it is. It's right down to the back of her knees, and I've dressed her up like a figure skater, because I am a figure skater. So yeah, so that's the thing you do with if you're a doll person and you've got your own hobbies, you like to give your dolls the same hobbies as well. So anyway, so yeah, I rerouted this. There's lots of rerouting videos on YouTube. Mine is on YouTube. I did mine different to anybody else because it wasn't working for me, what I'd seen on YouTube. However, I think it was my poor gadget. Now, if I ever do any rerouting again, I might actually get a new hair rerouting tool, and then I'll try it on the way other people have done it. But I had to do it a way that suited me, basically. I tried all different things, but yeah, I got there in the end anyway. Well, anyway, this doll, you might think, surely she's got a twist. She hasn't. It's a plait. Well, if you're in America, you call them braids. We call them plaits here. I don't know what I'd call this, a twist. I don't know. I don't know the official name for these in the UK. It's not something that I was brought up with in my hair. My Barbies had it, and Cindy, but not myself. But today, this girl is hopefully going to get the twisty treatment when I unbox my doll. So here she is, and I have taken a photograph, actually my own photograph of this downstairs, so I'll pop that up on the screen. And my box is a bit damaged actually, but as it was not a gift, it's for me, and I wasn't too fussed. And I did take a photograph of the back of this. I'll pop that on the screen. It might be better for you to look at it like that. Now, she's really pretty. Her face. Now, I've got many, many a Barbie doll, and she hasn't got the usual Barbie face. Now, I'm not a massive fan of plastic clothing. You know, the clothing that is stuck. Excuse me, I need to wipe my nose. Bear with me. Sorry about that. I'm going to just have a sip of my hot chocolate. I did put cream on it, but and marshmallows, but the cream's all gone flat now. Let's check I've not got a chocolate moustache. I should have had my Barbie mug here, shouldn't I, and drank out of that. Well, anyway, I'm going to get this doll out now. I might cut bits out when there's a bit of noise, because you probably don't want to hear that on YouTube. So here she is out of the box, and she comes with a lovely big brush. I was, admit, I thought I'd need a brush for brushing that doll's hair, but this one comes with it, so I won't need to go looking for one. And it looks a really decent brush, actually. Right, she's out. Little scissors. These are embroidery scissors, actually, which I've ruined getting into doll boxes. But yeah, Barbie was pretty easy to get out. Lots of little snips. And then I just had to pop a few bits out of this plastic. So yeah, easy enough to do. So anyway, her hair is gorgeous, actually. As I was saying, I'm not a massive fan of plastic clothing because you can't change their clothes. However, if you really are in love with a doll, then you could actually, you know, put her on a yoga body, couldn't you? And here she is. Now, I'm not going to mess around with this doll too much in this video. I'll mess with the other doll because I want to photograph her and video her, which I will pop any photographs and videos of this doll in at the end for you to see her up close with, you know, no messy background. So I've just moved her coloured bits of hair away, and I'm going to give it a brush. It's extremely long. I think it might be longer than the hair that I've rerouted on that other doll. Now, rerouting is a bit painstaking, but I think it's one of those things it's really good to have done as a doll collector, whatever I am. And yeah, and then you feel quite proud of the doll that you've done her hair. Actually, I'll just give this doll's hair a bit of a brush. I'll put them next to each other, actually. Yeah, not too much in it. I would say that this doll's hair is a bit longer and the hair is maybe slightly more buttery, but not much in it at all. Right. Oh, sorry. I use my phone to film and I've got messages coming up from Etsy, from an Etsy seller. So anyway, so here Barbie has got coloured pieces of hair and these appear to be rooted in, which I'm really, really excited about, actually. She's got like orange coming from her parting going this way. She's got a would you call this like a turquoise kind of green, or aqua maybe, coming out of a parting and going the opposite direction. And then a bit further along, let me see, I don't know if I've messed this up actually. No, these are going the same direction and there's a blue, really bright blue, like a parrot blue, and a real bright purple. And they're loads of fun. Now, I must admit, I'll be tempted to. I've had colour in my hair before, many, many years ago. I've had a red, a few red streaks in a clump. I used to have my ends in bright red tipped red and things. But yeah, I would like a strip of colour in my hair. Maybe I'll ask my hairdresser. I might take these out in a moment, actually. I've clipped it up after I've curled it. But yeah, the reason I left it up is because I wanted you to see the twist. So I'm hoping that's what this Barbie tool that comes is going to achieve. That would be nice, wouldn't it? So this is what her dress is like. It's a plastic top and it's a skirt with an elasticated waist, basically. And she looks like this. Sorry, Barbie, showing your bottom. She's got a very nice bottom, so she's got nothing to worry about, has she? Now, she's got quite basic articulation. She doesn't bend at the elbows, not like, you know, these yoga bodies. But obviously the joints can look a bit unsightly on photographs, can't they? So, you know, the swings and roundabouts. I do like the dolls with no joints for other reasons sometimes. And her knees don't bend either. So, you know, she's not as easy to play with. And she's got flats. Oh dear, Barbie, all dressed up like this and you got flats on. Now they look like a ballet style shoe with a little tie, a plastic tie at the back. And but she's lovely. It's a rainbow skirt, very bright. Now I would have absolutely loved this as a child as well. I used to have in my second bedroom, because my first bedroom I had Holly Hobby bedroom, and then we moved house and I had something called Starbright, and it was a little blonde cartoon girl with a little unicorn, and it was all about the rainbows. I had rainbows all over my bedroom then, so it was a lot more patchwork and more muted colours in my first bedroom, and then very overkill bright in my second bedroom. But yeah, very much like this. And she's lovely, isn't she? So anyway, I'm going to put her down now. I'll show you the other accessories that came with this. There's these little clips, which again I will video these at the end so you can see them properly. I'm guessing these are to clip your twists, and they're basically, I know they don't look like it, but they're bow, you know, clouds with a rainbow going over the top, but they're just one colour rainbow, not a rainbow multicolour. And there's these ones as well, and I'm guessing these are to clip your twists as well. They are little, they look like jewels. And there's purple, yellow, pink and green, you know, that aqua green, not as deep as this one. I would call that aqua green, that like a turquoise green, would you? Quite close to blue in colour. I don't know how it looks to you on the screen, actually. They can look very different. But yes, I will video these for you. But yeah, I'm guessing I'm going to have to use these unless I use a hair bobble. Now, the elastics that come on your doll boxes are quite useful for tying up hair, but I've cut them all, so I can't use any of them. Now, this is the gadget. Now, this is the one I use on my hair, and this is the one for Barbie. Now, these work by, you lift this up and it clips into your hair. Now, you only use two strands of hair for this. this it appears to be three. And basically you clip two pieces of hair in, you push the clip up and it separately twists the two bits of hair, the two bunches of hair that you've got. Then you put the lever down and then it twists them together. So I don't know how this works, but it does come with instructions. So I'm just going to just turn this video off a moment, briefly. We like nothing to you, and I'll just read the instructions and I'll come back to you. Right, I've read the instructions. Now, basically, this does a very similar thing to my one. Basically, you've only got one button. You've got mine, you go up and down. But you, one of them, that purple one doesn't do anything, apparently. That stays still. And then let me just press this a minute. Press that yellow star and it should do that to start with. And then it would, ooh. So basically you press it and it will twist, and then after you keep pressing and then it will twist them together like that. I thought you had to change it yourself, but you don't. So every time you start, you need to press that yellow thing. So basically you can't clip any hair into this. This is why I thought you can't use it on other dolls, but it's not the case. Basically, Barbie has got these things on the end of her hair, and I've got to basically get those off and put them on one of my doll's hair. Now, I don't know if you can see, basically, they've kind of just put the hair through there and then tied a little elastic on, and it's got this bit at the end. So I'm going to get this off and try and attach it. Well, attach two of them to my doll's hair, the one I rerouted. So bear with me. Right, I apologise if there's going to be any noise now. My next door neighbour are having work done out the front and they can be a bit noisy. So I apologise in advance if you hear anything. So basically, I've taken two of the clips out and and the bobbles, the elastic bobbles, and I've left it folded up on itself like this, and I've put some of those clips in, you know, the ones that came with the doll. I've just basically sandwiched them between there, so just her twists won't come out. Obviously, I did say I didn't want to mess with that doll too much because I'm going to photograph her. But yeah, there was no choice. I needed these to put on my doll so I can do it. So I'm going to do it the opposite end to her plait. I'm going to basically take two sections of hair. Now these clips will actually be good. I've taken one section of hair, just clipping that section away, separating it like that, just while I get the next section of hair. A bit like what I do with my own hair. When I'm working on a piece of hair, I try and get the other bits out of the way. It's probably good I haven't let my hair down, actually, because I might be getting it all tangled up in Barbie's machine. So, right, I've got two strands of hair now. Not two strands, but two bunches of hair. And I'm going to attempt threading them through. Now, I don't know how. I might do it with a piece of yarn, maybe. That's a good idea. Cut a length of yarn. Doesn't really matter what size, as long as it's manageable. Now I'm going to put the two ends of the yarn together and I'm going to put them through that loop. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put one of the bunches of hair of Barbie's in that loop and then pull it through. That is my plan. Now I'm putting Barbie's, that particular bunch of hair, through the yarn like that, and then what I'll have to do is keep this taut, and then I'm going to pull on that in that direction. It's a shame I can't film this. I could film this another time if you want to see it closer. Obviously I don't even know if it's going to work yet. Yes, it's worked. So now the yarn's come out and Barbie's hair is on there. So now I've got to fold Barbie's hair up on itself in half like that. And I need to attach it, which I was thinking of using that elastic, but no. I'm just going to put a clip at the bottom to stop that sliding off while I do the other one. So that's what I've done. Look, I've got the plastic on there, but I've just put that on there to keep hold of it. So now I've got the other star and loop. I'm going to put my two yarn ends into it. Luckily, I've always got yarn to hand because I knit and crochet and things. I've always got thread because I sew. But there we go. That one's on there. Now I'm just going to do what Barbie, that the doll came like. I'm folding the hair up away from it like that. It loops round, and I'm going to attach a clip that came with the doll like that. Now I'm going to do that with the other one. I've got a clip on there at the moment, but I haven't turned it in on itself, which I'm going to do now. So there we go. There's a little bit of faff, but we've got there. Let's get other bits of hair out of the way, like that. So now we're going to put them in the gadget. So I've stuffed them into the hole. See, it's done the twist, that's what mine's like, and I do mine. Now it's twisting it. Ooh. And there we go. I'm actually really chuffed about this because I've wanted one for Barbie for so long. That's amazing. So I'm going to take these out. So I'll just pull the stars out. Now what I do with my hair is I just put a bobble in it straight away. I clip them together. So I'm pulling the stars off the ends. And I've just pulled the clips off. So now I've just got to hold it with my hand. And I'm going to get one of these clips. I'm going to use the pink one because it goes with her outfit. The pink one doesn't want to hold, actually. Maybe the hair is too thick. Oh, right. I didn't spot something. I've got something I can show you. I can't open these clips. I just use my teeth then. You should never, don't do that, because you should never use your teeth as tools. I was a dental nurse, so I know. So there we go. She's got a twist like me. So, and now, and she got a plait on the other side. Now, what I didn't notice, that what I've just noticed is, if you don't want to use these, like I didn't have to take those off Barbie after all, because these have got the things on them for twisting Barbie's hair, look. So you can clip it in and just twist it in. You don't have to actually thread Barbie's hair through that if you don't want to. So that was something I did for nothing, basically. But yeah, but that's nice. So anyway, I'm going to let my my hair down. This I've curled with a tongue. I'm going to do another video now. When I finish filming this one, I'm going to do a Stitch Diary video. So I'll have nice hair for my Stitch Diary video. They normally see me in the right state sometimes. So there we go. Us girlies, we've all got our twists. Shall flatten that bit out. That's my, I just see my slough in the background. I'll just put it there. So here we go. twisty hair girls. It's been loads of fun bringing this video to you, and stay with me because at the end there'll be a little video that I'll put together with the dolls and you can see everything up close. So thank you so much for joining me on this episode of the doll hair, we got the hair diaries today, isn't it? So, but yeah, the doll diaries, and hopefully I won't leave it so long till the next one, and I'll see you next time. Bye.